Hello friends, welcome to GT Science Tutorial. In this video, I'm going to explain about the Frank Condon principle. This principle is very useful because this principle connects vibrational energy level and electronic energy level, as well as a very big problem in spectroscopy is solved by this principle. So what is that problem and what is Frank Condon principle? In this video, we are going to see everything about that. So let's start. Before understanding Frank Condon principle, we need to understand the vibrational spectra and vibrational energy level. We know that when we provide IR radiation or vibrational energy to a molecule, then the molecule vibrates like this, okay? And when the molecule vibrates, we get vibrational spectra. Now, when the molecule vibrates, we get some kind of curve. Let's talk about that curve first of all. In y-axis, we consider potential energy. In x-axis, we consider internuclear distance of the molecule. Now let's consider a molecule AB, where A is over here and B is over here. So this is the molecule and this is the internuclear distance between them, that is R. Now when we provide vibrational energy, then this B will vibrate and it comes here. And if we keep increasing the energy, then obviously the internuclear distance of the molecule keeps on changing, that is increasing on vibration. So you can see over here the internuclear distance is increasing like this, right? So now if we keep increasing the energy of the molecule, that is the if we keep providing vibrational energy to the molecule, then at a condition the energy will be so high that the molecule will break its bond. The molecular bond will obviously break and we get a curve like this. So this is the curve that we obtain in vibrational spectra. Now we got this curve, but in the beginning, I have already told you Frank Condon principle relates vibrational energy level and electronic energy level. And we know that electronic energy is always higher than the vibrational energy. That means if we provide electronic energy over here, then some electron will go on excitation, right? The electrons will excite and it will vibrate. The molecule will vibrate in excited state as well. And we get similar type of curve. Now, when it excites, there are two possibilities that we get. Let's talk about the two possibilities. Then we will talk about the Frank Condon principle. Let's talk about the two possibilities. Now, I have made the two diagrams over here. You might be wondering why I made two diagrams, right? So, when the energy increases, that means when we provide UV radiation or electronic energy, obviously, there will be a transition of the molecule, right? When the molecule transits, then we get a similar type of curve over here as well. That means the molecule will vibrate in higher potential energy level as well. Now, there are two possibilities. In the first possibility, somehow, let us consider the internuclear distance of the molecules do not change. That is less likely to occur, right? As we are providing higher energy, so technically the internuclear distance should increase, right? So in the first possibility, we consider a case in which the internuclear distance do not increase. That sounds funny, isn't it? So let's consider that like this. Okay, here the internuclear distance is not changing at all. So this is V prime is equal to 0, V prime is equal to 1, V prime is equal to 2, V prime is equal to 3. This V is the vibrational energy level. V prime is also the vibrational energy level, but in excited state. And in second case, let us consider that after we provide the energy, the internuclear distance between the molecule changes, that is increases. And this is more likely to occur. And we get a curve like this, right? Here the internuclear distance has increased, obviously. So this is V prime is equal to 0, V prime is equal to 1, V prime is equal to 2, and V prime is equal to 3. So these are the two possibilities that we might get. In the first case, the internuclear distance between the molecule do not change even in excited state. In the second case, the internuclear distance between the molecules changes, that is increases. Okay, now which one of them is correct? Theoretically, this should be correct, right? As it is getting energy, so this should be correct. But practically, we got this curve. We get this curve when we do practical. How? Why do we get this curve? What might be the reason for this curve? This was a very big issue. Then Frank Condon gave a principle that solved the problem of getting this type of curve instead of getting this type of curve. Okay. Now here the Frank Condon principle is applied. Frank Condon principle says that electronic transition occurs so rapidly that the vibrational molecules do not change its internuclear distance appreciably during the transition. Let me write it over here. Okay, let me write the principle over here. It states that, it means Frank Condon principle, okay? It states that electronic transition takes place so rapidly that during the transition the internuclear distance, that is R, we have denoted internuclear distance of the molecule by R, the R of the vibrating molecule, R of the vibrating molecule do not change appreciably. Okay, so this is what Frank Condon said. They said that electronic transition takes place so rapidly that during the transition, the R, that is the internuclear distance of the vibrating molecules, do not change appreciably. Let us consider that by a simple experiment. Not experiment, let's see, okay. Suppose this is the vibrating molecule, okay. These are the two markers. This is the first molecule, this is the first atom, this is the second atom, A and B, okay. So these are vibrating like this, as we have considered A to be fixed and B is vibrating like this, okay. Now, if we provide UV radiation, that is electronic energy, then an electron will go up and come down, right? Now, during that time, the nucleus do not know that it's one of the electron has already excited and came down, okay. The reason for that is the speed of the electron is extremely high as compared to the speed of the nucleus. We know that this is the atomic structure, right? Here it is the nucleus. Let me denote nucleus by capital N, and there is the electron. Obviously, nucleus is very happy as compared to electron. So, electron will move very fast as compared to the nucleus. So, the electron will go up and come down. During that time, the vibrating molecule will be kept vibrating like this, and when it knows that my electron has got up and down, when it completes one vibration, its electron might have already gone up and came down. Okay, this is so rapid process. Because of that, we only get this type of curve, that is the internuclear distance does not change even in excited state. Isn't it interesting? You might have watched the movie Avengers Endgame, one of the biggest movie in the world, right? In that movie, there is a scene in which the Hulk time travels and he goes to take the time stone from there. And while taking the time stone, he comes to know that if he takes the time stone, there will be a disruption in time, right? So he promises to come back in time and put the time stone over there. So he takes the time stone from there and they kill Thanos, and Captain America returns, goes in the past to give the time stone and put it to the original place, right? Now, this is that condition. Hulk takes the time stone like this, okay? It goes here and Captain America puts it over here, and the time that should have happened do not even know that it exists. That means the time period, that disrupted time period do not even happen. This is that disrupted time period that you can consider, okay? This should have happened, but that speed of the electron is extremely large as compared to the speed of the nucleus, so we get this curve, okay? That was a very bad example. I hope you understood about this, okay? So this is the curve that we get, and this curve is explained by Frank Condon principle, okay? Now you can see over here, from zero the electron will transit to zero, right? Here the probability of finding electron is maximum in this region. Now here in V1, this is the region where electron will be found. In here, this is the region where electron will be found, right? So from zero the electron can go anywhere on this level, in this energy, sorry, in this curve as well. So from zero it can go to zero, but as we can see over here, the probability of finding electron is maximum in V0, so we get the largest peak or the highest peak in 0,0. That is, it starts from zero, that is the V from V0 to V'0. Here if you see that, if it excites, it does not go to zero at all. It directly goes to V'0, 0, 2, and it is very much less likely to happen, okay? So this is the correct curve that we get practically, and Frank Condon principle explains why we get this type of curve, and that is all because of the speed of the electron and the nucleus. And don't forget about that example, okay? That Bruce Banner, Hulk, Thanos, Captain America, Time Stone, okay? I'm a very big fan of Marvel, so I literally thought of that example. Okay, so this is what Frank Condon principle actually is. I hope you understood everything about Frank Condon principle. That's all in this video. If you like the video, please share this video as much as you can. And thank you for watching the video.